You're tuned in to the Daily Top 10, your one stop to the most trending entertainment and lifestyle news, brought to you by your number one entertainment channel, 9GZ Extreme. At number 10, Queen Elizabeth II dies at 96. It is a mix of emotions, some bittersweet moments, because while the earth stands still at the passing of one of the most gracious persons to ever walk on her ground, the heavens rejoice. After ascending the throne in 1952, at the age of 25 and ruling the United Kingdom till her death for 70 years, which makes her the longest serving monarch ever, Queen Elizabeth II has passed on in what took the world by surprise. A rude shock, I must say. It will interest you to know, however, that the strong Arsenal fan was an active member of the World War, where she served as a mechanic until her death. She served the people, she served her land, which reflected in the level of growth and development that the nation has enjoyed so far. As the British family gather to mourn, we await an official address from the new king, her son, who will be regarded as King Charles III. Rest in peace, Queen Mother. Still on the Queen's passing, at number 9, may her pain be excruciating, Uju Anya. Even as different nations of the earth continue to mourn the death and celebrate the life of the late monarch, Queen Elizabeth II, who according to a statement made by the Buckingham Palace, died peacefully at the Balmoral Castle in the later hours of Thursday, September 8th. Condolences have continued to pour in online and offline. However, there has been an unpopular opinion by a Pennsylvania-based Nigerian professor, Uju Anya, who wrote, "I heard the chief monarch of a thieving, molesting, genocide empire is finally dying. May her pain be excruciating." As expected, this tweet, which has now been taken down, caught the attention and reaction of many, to include that of the richest person in the world, Jeff Bezos. In his response to the professor, he wrote, "This is someone supposedly working to make the world better? I don't think so. Wow. Wow, wow, wow." At number 8, Asake releases debut album, Mr. Money with the Vibe. Right now, Asake, one of Nigeria's international artists with a unique sound, texture, and style, has released his debut album titled Mr. Money with the Vibe. After releasing his debut EP, Ololademi Asake, in 2021, although leaving out some of his hit songs like Omokwe, Shunga, Trabaye, and Palazzo, his MMWTV body of work with songs like Reason featuring Grouse, Muse, Nzanza, and Joha has crossed various charts to be number one in less than 24 hours. And number 7, Hush Puppy's jail term reduced to 11 years. You will recall that Nigerian socialite Ramzan Abbas, popularly known as Hush Puppy, was arrested in June 2020 in Dubai and later transferred to the United States. But as against the initial long jail term, the US government has now hacked to his plea for a shorter sentence after meeting up to his memorandum countering sentencing recommendations of the prosecutors assured a well-mannered inmate. As a result, Hush Puppy will now only spend 11 years in prison. That's still quite some time. Moving on to number 6, somehow everything dies in this country, Yu Edochi. It is interesting how Nollywood veteran actor and filmmaker come politician Yu Edochi has made himself a talking point in recent times. It's either family, politics, work, or even his fans. Taking to his Instagram page only a short while ago to express his dissatisfaction and worry in the rise of unprofessionality in the film industry, among other things, he wrote, "Nollywood has turned to dumping ground for blockheads. Even people that can't speak good English have become actors and actresses unlike before. Nollywood don't suffer. Somehow, everything dies in this country. Why?" If you ask me, now who I go ask? Why? Moving on to number 5, 19-year-old Carlos Alcaraz advances to US Open semifinals. The ongoing edition of the US Open Tennis Championship Tournament has yet again witnessed an outstretched length of play between 19-year-old Spanish tennis player Carlos Alcaraz Garcia and Italian player Jannik Sinner. It is recorded that the duo played for 5 hours, after which Carlos Alcaraz eventually won, advancing him to his first Grand Slam semifinals, where he will be playing against Francis Tiafoe. This makes him the first youngest player to reach the semifinals since 1990. At number 4, even at war, music is life. Ukraine's Ministry of Defense has earlier celebrated some of the Ukraine's victories in the ongoing war against Russia, using the lyrics to one of Pusha T's songs, Numbers on the Board, to describe the feeling that comes with winning, with a caption, and put numbers on the board at Pusha T, total combat losses of the enemy from February. Responding to the tweet, Pusha T wrote, great taste of music for the win. Music, they're doing the most.
Fuckers can't rhyme no more, about crime no more.
Mix drug and show money, Biggs Burke on tour. 25 bricks, move work like chore. Hit Delaware twice, needed 25 more. I see flaw, cracks in your diamond. CB4, when you rhyme, Simple Simon. Come and meet the pieman, a must that I flaunted. The legend grows legs when it comes back to haunt us. Ballers, I put numbers on the boards. Can't a bitch live and say I bought a Michael Kors. Every car driven was decided by a horse. Keep the sticker in the window case you wonder.
Okay, at number 3, glad my brain started working again, says Eminem. American rapper Eminem bears it all in a chat with his longtime manager Paul Rosenberg on his podcast show. They spoke extensively on Eminem's life-threatening drug overdose in 2007, which he referred to as a wake-up call to get sober, which he says he has been on since April 2008. In his words, I remember when I first got sober and all that stuff was out of my system. I remember just being like really happy and everything was new to me again. With regards to recording during the process, he says it was the first album and the first time he had fun recording in a long time and started having fun with music again and relearning how to rap. And he also remembered that the whole process took a long time for his brain to start working properly again. Good thing Eminem is better now. At number 2, Nines drops Tip of the Iceberg 2, the album. Award-winning Nigerian veteran artist has finally given us a Tip of the Iceberg 2. 2 years after Tip of the Iceberg 1 dropped. As expected, the Gangnam Style chrono delivered on every song, giving us a blend of Fuji, Afala, and of course, Afrobeats. The album features Tiwa Savage, Ricardo Banks, Zlatan, Bella, Shmuda, and more. At number 1, Brymer assures fans of an album in 2023. In an audiovisual shared online, Nigerian singer-songwriter and sonic artist Olawale Olufuru, aka Brymer, has in what he refers to as a public announcement revealed that he will be dropping his next studio album in the last quarter of the year 2023. We're excited and await the magic. This is where we draw the curtain on today's edition of the Daily Top 10. Till I come your way again next time, do well to follow us on all of our social media platforms at 9GZ Extreme for more updates. Thanks for staying tuned and have a lovely, lovely weekend.
This is a public service announcement, of course, to let you all know that my next studio album will be called Macabre and will be in stores for the last quarter of 2023. I'm sure you're wondering, where is Mansa? Where is Mansa? Yes, Mansa is my debut as a sonic artist. This means that distribution, presentation, everything for Mansa will be very, very different. And I cannot wait to share that whole new system with you.